A desert Haboob during a football game? Mother Nature decided to spice things up during last night's ASU game. It's the season opener in Tempe against Southern Utah. The sun is out and absolutely no sign of dust, lightning, or rain. Some pre-victory fireball shots and we're off to watch the Sun Devils play some football on this fine Thursday night. It's good to be back in Sun Devil Stadium, and yes, that's what I'll continue calling it versus this new crap that nobody wanted. Sparky stomps the bus and the Devils take the field. College football is officially back about damn time. These next few months are my favorite time of the year, and 8 of the 12 games will be played here in Tempe. I still don't understand how that happened, but I'm not mad about it. We've got a new starting quarterback. True freshman Jaden Rashada takes the field, and the Devils score on the first offensive drive. Running back Cam Scapebo runs it in for the first touchdown of the season. Here comes the extra point. The kick is up, and... oh man, that was shitty timing for some guy to walk to his seat. Anyways, more celebratory fireball shots with the birthday boy. It's tradition, duh. Southern Utah bounces back in the first quarter, making the score now 7-7. The play of the night. On 4th and 8 from the pitchfork, Rashada throws one deep and it's caught by Xavier Gilroy for a touchdown. More fireworks in Tempe, and then things get interesting with the weather. The Phoenix Valley in August is known for monsoons and haboobs. However, in all my years of living here and going to ASU games, I've never experienced something like this at Sun Devil Stadium. A huge wall of wind and dust entered from the southeast corner, making it extremely hard to see anything on the football field. You couldn't even see the words that read Frank Cushfield on the press box building. There was so much dust in the air that it actually burned my eyes and hurt to keep them open. It was a sight I've never seen. Consider this the halftime show for the night. The wind was blowing the beer right out of my cup, some of the strongest weather I've ever felt in a long time. I'm usually never one to leave at halftime, but it was the obvious thing to do as fans were exiting the stadium in herds. There was lightning a few miles away, and ASU announced that they'll be on a weather delay for a while and encourage all fans to leave and find shelter. 2.5 hours later, and the Devils start the second half at 11 p.m. at night. The game finally comes to an end at 1 a.m., and I wake up to quite the scare of the final score being 21-24 ASU. We're 1-0 in the Kenny Dillingham era and have Oklahoma State coming to Tempe next Saturday. See you there!